envision this blood-stained tomb, beer cans and piss. This is no life for a god.
Slave Pit Incorporated, makers of fine filth for a quarter of a century, proudly presents Live from Antarctica. Witness history in this star-studded night of celebration. Performing a career-capping set from the front steps of their temple, stronghold, fortress, and convenience store, it's the GWAR 25th Anniversary Extravaganza Concert. It all begins right here in 10 excruciatingly short minutes. But first...
The year was 1980-something. Disco had breathed its last coke-fueled breath, and glam metal was beginning to show the signs of the cancerous decay that was eating the music scene from deep within its own nasal cavities. This was the landscape that gave witness to the birth of the musical group that would over the past 25 years become the unstoppable phenomenon that is known to the world as the undisputed kings of splatter metal and the most dangerous band in the universe, GWAR. But where did they come from? How did they get here? What makes them tick? Find out tonight as we explore the ups and downs of their 25-year career in music on a very special episode of GWAR Behind the Murder. New York City, 1985. An enterprising young record executive and pimp named Sleazy P. Martini was about to make a discovery that would change not only his life, but the entire world of music forever. How to make crack cocaine.
Don't get me wrong, fucko. I was on a fast track to a presidential bid in 86. But within 2 weeks of me inventing crack, I had real power and influence.
With great power comes great big pains in the ass, and Sleazy P. Martini was about to attract the attention of the biggest ass in the world, the U.S. government. With the DEA, FBI, CIA, PTA, U.S. Army, and the Marauding Squad hot on his trail, he fled, quite literally, to the end of the ends of the earth.
I stole a helicopter and I flew to the South Pole. And just when I thought I was home free, I was blinded by snow. I ended up crashing somewhere in Antarctica. I was sure I was gonna freeze to death, but then I stumbled into an ancient tomb.
Facing certain death, Sleazy P makes a find that will change the face of modern music when GWAR Behind the Murder continues, right now.
Oh, we're on? Then I stumbled into a tomb, and these frozen monsters woke up and yelled, GWAR!
Gwarg. An unlikely name for an unlikable group of demigods. After GWAR scared off the army, Martini brought them back to New York and gave them instruments and more crack, and the rock group band GWAR was born.
We've been frozen for thousands of years. That can really take a lot out of a guy. Those first few shows, we looked like shit. And we were black and white.
Word soon spread of a murderous gang of musicians that was leaving in their path across North America, a wake of corpses of their critics and fans alike. But what exactly were they? Clearly they weren't human, as is evident by observing lead singer Odorous Urungus's enormous cock. Guitarist Ballsack the Jaws of Death's steel face. Bassist Beefcake the Mighty's massive girth. Guitarist Flatus Maximus's wretched stench. And drummer Chismack the Gusher's dogged good looks.
We're not from Antarctica. We aren't even from Earth. This is just where we were imprisoned after getting kicked out of the Master's, I don't know, third scumdog legion.
The Master, a planet-sized butt, who according to GWAR created all reality in an act of flatulence, banished GWAR to Earth after they mistakenly destroyed the peaceful planet of Flabquerb 6 instead of its hostile neighbor, Flabquerb 7.
Earth sucks. All we've been trying to do the past 25 years is get back to outer space. But our manager, Sleazy, keeps making us go out on these stupid tours.
Over the years, GWAR has come tantalizingly close to their dream of returning to the cosmos. They tried stealing a space shuttle, hitching a ride with gray aliens, and waking the world maggot, an enormous worm that slept beneath the Earth's crust, so they could ride it back home. But each attempt ended in consummate failure.
Maybe there's two world maggots.
Next, on Behind the Murder, Otis's many run-ins with the law.
Let me set the record straight. I thought the whale was a prostitute.
That's next on Behind the Murder, after this brief commercial break.
Slide Backyard Fun from Reamco. Sperm not included.
Over the years, GWAR has fought a myriad of foes, both Earth-based and extraterrestrial. But their toughest opponents have always been their own kind, the Techno Brothers. Techno Destructo, Bozo Destructo, and most recently, Sawborg Destructo. Scumdog soldiers still loyal to the Master that have been sent to Earth many times to try to destroy GWAR and end their deviant ways.
I hate those dicks. Why won't they just leave us alone? I mean, we're not really hurting anyone. Except the millions of humans that we mutilate nightly.
And there were hints of far greater dangers for GWAR. Lurking in outer space, waiting to unleash their vengeance upon the scumdogs. Like the near omnipotent Cardinal Sin, a force that seeks to homogenize the entire universe into a soulless mass of bland followers who blindly serve his church.
My war fleet will be arriving in the next movie.
But the next movie came and went, and the one after that, 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 and still Cardinal Sin's threat went unfulfilled. Despite the fact that they were murdering their fans at an appalling rate, GWAR's fame continued to grow.
The deals kept coming in. We had the Saturday morning cartoon, the breakfast cereal, the sports drink. We even had our own line of tampons.
Fortune rained down upon GWAR, but the rain clouds soon turned stormy.
I was spending wheelbarrows full of 20s just to buy wagons full of crack. Sometimes I got so high, I just smoked the cash. That got me high too. I like getting high.
The years dragged on for these once proud scumdog warriors, as one drug-filled night bled into the next. The road can extract a heavy toll even on extraterrestrial demigods, and GWAR ran out of nickels for that toll one cold November night in Wichita.
Otis's crack habit was really getting out of control. There were some problems, then there were solutions to the problems, then the solutions became the problems, and that's when things came to a head, and the head got some lumps on it.
The mayhem spilled out into the frigid Kansas night and continued for 3 solid weeks.
After the fight, we couldn't even stand to look at each other. I didn't even want to play music anymore. I had to find something else to do.
That something else took many forms. Balsack became a high school English teacher. Flattis, a telemarketer. Jismack pursued a career in professional sports. And Beefcake the Mighty started an organic arugula farm.
I can't tell you how many lives I ruined with my hopeless crack addiction. All I can tell you is that I don't give a shit. I was high. High as fuck. Thank you.
As for Otis Urungus, he returned to his first love, acting, in pornography. But the world wouldn't let GWAR end. Within hours of the breakup, a reunion show was announced. And who was footing the bill for this massive event? The multi-gazillion dollar megacorporation, Glomco.
I don't know why the fuck Glomco would sponsor us. I don't really think they have our...
Attention, attention, citizens of Earth. Please remain calm. This is Cardinal Sin. I have created a sin virus that removes all impure thoughts from the host body. My Sinite warriors are working their way through the galaxy, inoculating all living things, effectively curing the universe of deviance and immorality, once and for all. Resistance is futile, as the antidote can only be made using the blood of this baby. Where's the baby? Someone has stolen the same child. Alert, alert! All warriors to battle stations, retrieve the child.
Mayday, mayday! This is Starborg Destructo on the scumdog warship SS Cripple Killer, coming in hot!
Quick! Starborg! Take the baby and eject before these Sin warriors capture him!
No, you!
No, you!
No, you!
Live from Antarctica, celebrating 25 years of total domination, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for GWAR!
There's a place!
We'll be right back.
like we got us a scumdog warship! You motherfuckers ready to take a little trip back to outer space?
We'll be right back.
run! The end of run! The end of run! The end of run! I am the ruiner! The mutilator of dreams! Our life falls apart in the sand! Now fight us!
Enough with the jokes. Let's get down to some real business. You know that guy with the pointy hat that just sprayed that shit all over you? Well, they infected you and these pathetic humans with a sin virus. If we don't find the antidote, you will become homeless and gay. Not homeless.
Oh, wait a minute, man. I don't want to be homeless. Where would I bring people back to suck their cocks if I was homeless?
Yeah, that's right. But anyways, Odorous, I found this asshole with the pointy hat in the bowels of our ship. Your enemy at your mercy, Odorous.
Well, very good, Sawborg. Maybe there's hope for you yet. Let's see how much blood this motherfucker has got inside of him.
In the world, and no matter.
to be back in Richmond, Virginia. Capital of the Confederacy. Home of motherfucking Marlboro cigarettes. But nevertheless, there's a question on our minds tonight. As we left your planet, we wanted to find some of the old motherfuckers we hung out with. This guy. He was our old general back in the Scumdog Warfleet. And right now, all we want to know is the answer to one question. Where is Zog?
Cool. He's really changed.
I used to look up to that man, dude, yeah. Man. You like, see what will fucking happen if you let crack rule your life?
No.
Fuck.
No. It's a baby.
What
a
the fuck?
A delicious, juicy baby.
There's some kind of baby floating around outside
get
the
it.
Ship.
Get it. Get
I'll
it.
Tell you one thing. If I had that baby in here right now, I would fuck the living shit out of it.
Give us it.
Oh. Hey, Clark. Fancy meeting you out here. Your baby acting up?
It's Michael Jackson. We thought you were dead.
Hey, what's up?
I just thought I'd like to see what it was like out here in space. I always wanted to be a celestial molester. Permission to come on board?
What do you people think here in Richmond? You want to see Michael Jackson come out here and moonwalk with Otis? Of course you do! Ladies and gentlemen, Michael Jackson, let's get a bomb! Get a double big one later. All right, this is from my new album, Lost in Space. It's all is gone. Let us fly.
Down, 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 down
bleed in the blood of the sin baby! You shall be healed! Tell me to shove this fucking thing up my motherfucking baby, little twat!
Yeah!
Are you ready for the final apocalypse?
You think you have triumphed, but you haven't. The plan of sin is consummate, eternal, immaculate. But there is a price for your meddling. You must die!
Holy shit! Cardinal sins are coming! What?
This is all your fault! You and your crazy wacky doodle! Oh shit! There! There you go! That's what you wanted! Stop it! It's not on!
You all about. I'm gonna break records.
Thank you, Richmond! Thank you so fucking much! Justice to our brother!
Me as the President of the United States of America, and on behalf of the American people and all of the denizens of the planet Earth, I would like to offer my deepest thanks to the rock group band, GWAR. GWAR, you have saved this planet from an extraterrestrial threat of unimaginable power. As a token of Earth's undying gratitude, allow me to present you with this highest honor I can bestow, the Presidential Medal of Ass-Kicking Cool Shit. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. You'll freeze them out. Watching the fire, he's out of your view.
Come on.
25 years, it wouldn't have been nothing without our motherfucking hometown. Thank you so much, Richmond, Virginia.
This is it.